Incoming Philippine Central Bank Governor Felipe Medalla downplays the depreciation of the peso. He says it could be tempered by remittances, exports, and income from BPOs. He adds a weaker peso is mainly due to a strong dollar, which has become more attractive as a safe haven asset around the world due to uncertainties brought by the war in Ukraine. On Monday, the peso briefly touched the 55 level against the U.S. dollar, the lowest in 17 years, before recovering to 54.78. Meanwhile, the Philippines lands in the list of the 10 worst countries for working people. The International Trade Union Confederation's Global Rights Index 2022 cited violence and murder, arrests during strikes and state repression as threats for workers in the Philippines. It adds over 50 trade unionists have been killed since President Duterte came to power in 2016. Also in the list are Bangladesh, Belarus, Brazil, and two new entries, Eswatini and Guatemala. The report also says workers face record abuse of labor rights in the past year, from union bans to violence and murder. Physical violence was reported in 50 out of the 148 countries covered in the report. That's up from 45 countries in 2021.
The Office of the Prosecutor in Davao City dismisses the cyber libel complaints filed by Davao-based businessman Dennis Cui against ABS-CBN over its news reports. The Office of the Prosecutor said the complainants were dismissed due to lack of probable cause. Uy earlier claimed ABS-CBN stories on the Malafaya deal, which quoted the graft complaint against him, were libelous. But the prosecutor's office said they were not defamatory. Last week, outgoing Energy Secretary Alfonso Pusi withdrew his libel and cyber libel complaints against ABS-CBN and six other news organizations over their stories on the Malafaya deal. ABS-CBN is the parent firm of this news channel.
A look now at the financial markets. Wall Street closed sharply lower Tuesday as dire consumer confidence data dampened investor optimism and fueled worries over recession and the looming earnings season. The tech-heavy Nasdaq was a laggard, falling 3%, with Apple, Amazon, and Microsoft shares weighing the heaviest. The S&P 500 dropped 2%, while the Dow lost 491 points. Over in Europe, markets managed to rise even as global investor sentiment remains choppy due to recession fears.
Baseless. That's how Philippine Customs Commissioner Rey Leonardo Guerrero described allegations against him after he was tagged as a protector of agricultural smugglers in an intelligence report submitted to the Senate. Guerrero vehemently denied being involved in smuggling, emphasizing instead the part of the committee report that highlighted the accomplishments of the Bureau of Customs against the illegal activity. Other customs officials included in the list are also denying the accusations against them. The BOC has started an investigation into the matter.
Yes, we have personalities that are within our ranks and even from other agencies as well. No? Dun sa ano sa mga kasong final namin, I think yung mga ni-refer namin for investigation and proper appropriate filing of cases na mga government officials, ibinigay namin yun sa either sa Presidential Anti-Corruption Commission or sa Office of the Ombudsman.
Kuburan Cebu Mayor Aljun Jamante, who was also implicated in the smuggling of agricultural products into the country, challenged his accusers to back their claims. Senators Nancy Binay and Joel Villanueva, meanwhile, defended Nabotas Mayor Toby Champo. The senators believe the inclusion of Champo's name in the list is a result of failed intelligence. According to the committee report, 667.5 million pesos worth of agri-fishery commodities was smuggled into the Philippines from 2019 to 2022.
The Philippines' securities regulator has ordered the shutdown of online news website Rappler. That's according to Rappler CEO Maria Ressa herself. In a statement, Ressa shared at the East-West Center International Media Conference in Hawaii, Rappler said the Securities and Exchange Commission has affirmed its earlier decision to revoke the certificates of incorporation of Rappler Incorporated and Rappler Holdings Corporation. It was in 2018 when the SEC ruled that Rappler violated the constitutional prohibition on foreign ownership and control of mass media companies when it received an investment from an international firm. Ressa says they will appeal the decision. The SEC, meanwhile, has yet to confirm or comment on the supposed shutdown order. Rappler, which has been critical of Philippine President Rodrigo Duterte's war against illegal drugs, has been facing several cases filed by the government, including cyber libel, and describes the charges and acts against it as an attack on press freedom.